Hello everyone, today I'm going to be showing you how to make this trending zoom in or out and flicker effect on Premiere Pro. So to begin, you want to create an adjustment layer. So head to your project tab, right click, new item, adjustment layer, and click OK. Place this above your first clip. So for this one, I'm going to make a zoom in. So head into effects and search for transform. This one underneath distort, add it onto the adjustment layer and head back into effects controls. Set a keyframe for the scale at the very start. Head to the last frame and increase this to 150. So now you should have these two in total. What you want to do is just highlight them and then right click on one of them, select Bezier. Next, we're going to graph it. So you want to open up the graph by clicking on the arrow next to the stopwatch. That's going to bring down these two graphs. So there's this one at the top, which is much better than the one at the bottom. So I'm going to expand this to get a clearer view. You can do this by just hovering your cursor over this very faint line. It should be between these two graphs just here. So you want to just drag it down like so. And what you want to do is increase this value down here. So right now it's negative 200. So just increase this until the first point hits the bottom, and you want to decrease this one at the top or the second keyframe. So it should now look like this, which means we can now start graphing. So just copy what I do. I'm going to pull this up and pull this one down. So yeah, let's see how this looks so far. Okay, not bad at all. Feel free to make any adjustments. So for example, if it's too fast, then it's probably looking something like this and you don't want that. Otherwise, it's going to look kind of stiff. Make sure it looks like this. And also what you want to do is increase the motion blur. So if you scroll down, you'll see shutter angle. Increase this to 360. Then you want to push this last keyframe all the way to the very end. All right, that's the zoom in sorted. Next, we're going to make the zoom out. So once again, I'm going to place an adjustment layer on top of my second clip, add on the transform effect directly, head back into effect controls, and we're going to do it the other way around. So I'm going to keyframe it, but I'm going to set it to 100. And actually, let's go for 175 at the start. And if I head to the last frame, I'm going to reset it to 100. Then I'm going to highlight both of these keyframes, right click on one of them, select Bezier, open up the graphs and expand it to get a clearer view. I'm going to increase this value down here so that the second keyframe point reaches the bottom. I can leave this one, but I am just going to increase it very slightly. So 175 and 95. Okay, looks perfect. And you just want to graph like me. So push this one down and push this one up like so. Let's take a look. Not bad. I feel like it could be a little quicker. So I'm going to push this down a little. Let's see. Yep, looks perfect. So I'm going to increase the shutter angle 360 and push this last keyframe to the very end. And also, if you don't want a zoom out and you just want to add another zoom in, just get rid of this. And what you can do is hold Alt on your keyboard, click and drag the first adjustment layer over to your second one, and you now have a zoom in for both clips. However, I'm going to stick to my zoom in and zoom out. Next, we're going to add the flicker. So head to your project tab. You want to right click anywhere where it's empty, new item, color matte, click OK, and you want to set the color to white and click OK. Give it a name if you like. I'm just going to name it white. And what you want to do next is just drag it onto your timeline, place it above your adjustment layers. So what you want to do here is have three frames for both sides. So 1, 2, 3. I'm just going to extend that. 1, 2, 3. All right, that's already set. Select the color matte and head over to effect controls. Change the blend mode from normal to linear dodge add. Starting with the first frame, what I'm going to do is use the position to shift it to the left. So I'm just going to use the first value here and just drag it like so. That seems good. I'm also going to decrease the opacity down to 75. Head one frame ahead and make a cut. Now I'm going to shift it to the right instead. So maybe somewhere around here. I'm going to bring down the opacity a little bit more. So from 75 to 50. Then head one frame ahead and make a cut. And what you want to do is reset the opacity to 100. In addition, you want to reset the position. Head one frame ahead, make another cut, and you want to bring this one very slightly to the left. So I'm just going to drag it so that looks about fine, and I'm going to decrease the opacity to about 75. One frame ahead, make another cut, and I'm going to drag it to the middle, so somewhere around here. And now if I just scrub through it, it should look like this. So if I play it back in real time, you should get this flicker effect. Now, there are a few adjustments you can make. First of all, what you can do is head to this one, the third frame, and you can decrease the opacity a little bit. So we can go for something like 75. This makes the clip behind it a little more visible. And also what you can do is head one frame back. In fact, you want to drag the first cut that we made of the color mat one frame back, and you want to extend this second one to the left. Then what you want to do is cut the last one by one frame, so just drag it to the left. And as a result, this should hopefully have more impact and look like this. And that's how to make a trending zoom in or out plus flicker effect on Premiere Pro. Let me know what other trending effects you would like to see next. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Peace.